Hi, thanks for joining me. Today I'm going to show you how to make this Frankenstein box. And every year I always make a Frankenstein box or something with the Frankenstein face. And here is my whole box of different sizes. We have Kit Kat holder, another Kit Kat, post-it notes, boxes. They're a lot of fun. And so what I've used in the past was this hair, which was a grass die cut that we do not carry. So one of my downline girls showed me a picture that someone had used the spider web embossing folder and created a top for the box. So isn't that cute? So this is what we're going to make today. So that way we're not going to skip Frankenstein this year. So this box measures 9 by 5, and let me get my trimmer. We're going to score it on the long sides at 1 1/4 on each side, okay? So 1 1/4, and then turn it and score it at 1 1/4. Then we're going to go on the other side and score it at 3 1/2. And turn it and score at 3 1/2. Okay? Fold these on the score lines. Now I'm going to take my scissors and I'm going to cut up to the score line. This one as well. Okay, so before I put my adhesive, I'm going to go ahead and draw his mouth so that that way it's nice and flat here. I have several templates to draw Frankenstein's mouth. This is one of them that I've had for many years. But if you can't get your hands on this one, there are tons of other ones out there. There's this one that I bought a couple years ago, and you can see that this is the one I've used. But we're going to use this one because this is the one I've used for a lot of years. I like it. And I'm just going to line this up. We're going to make the eyes bigger. I determined after I made this that we had room to give him bigger eyes, and it makes him more dramatic. So I'm going to bring his mouth up about 1/2 inch from the bottom, and I'm trying to make sure that I'm in between the two score lines. Okay, so now let's go ahead and close this box up. So we're just going to build the walls here and then bring this up. And if you want to see how I figured out how to make, how to get the measurements to make this box, I did film this on Ustream, and so I show the whole process of how I figured out the measurements to get the lid for the box, okay? And this is Old Olive, but we're going to try out Pear Pizzazz for this video. Now, the black piece of cardstock for the top is 4 1/4 by 4 1/2, and we're going to score it at 1 inch on all four sides. Okay. Now, before I cut it, we're going to go ahead and use the punch. So I'm going to use the scallop border punch. Okay, now before I cut this, I'm going to go ahead and run it through the Big Shot using the spider web embossing folder. Okay, so I'm just going to place it just like that, and I'll be right back. Okay, so here we have it. Isn't that awesome? Now I'm going to fold it on those score lines. For some of you, it might be a little difficult to see them once you've embossed it, so you might want to go ahead and cut it if you're going to have a problem seeing it. I've got a lot of light here, so it's a little bit easier. And I'm just cutting up to that score line, okay? So we're going to put some adhesive on these four tabs that I just cut, okay? And just fold that over. Okay, so the white part of his eye is going to be the 1-inch circle punch. The black piece is going to be the 3/4-inch circle punch. And then his nose, I'm not sure, but I think we'll go with the 1-inch. And for his eyelids, we'll go with the 1-inch, I think. Yep. He has much bigger eyes. And then his nose is also the 1-inch, and we'll also cut that one in half, okay? So now we're going to do some sponging, pop up the eyelids. So I'm just going to use part of a dimensional. Okay, so I have those ready, but I'm going to sponge them first. Okay, so we're going to put the use the white gel pen for his eye, for the white part. We're going to use the two-way glue to attach it. So now let's sponge the box. And then we'll sponge these pair of pizzazz pieces, the eyelids and the nose. Okay, so we'll attach the nose first. And for this part, we want to go ahead and put the top of the box on, so we'll make sure that we get his eyes placed where we want them, because maybe, sorry, and I'm pushing that down, see, well, maybe we'll drop that nose down just a tad. I gotta stop pushing that. Okay, and one final step is we're just going to give him those little stitches or scar. I'm not real sure what it's called. And there you have it. So I'm not sure which one you like better, the big eyes or the little eyes. This is the 1-inch with the 3/4-inch, and this is the 3/4-inch with the 1/2-inch. So whichever you would prefer. Okay, thanks a lot. Bye.